Hi, I'm Elizabeth Gia. Welcome to Career Choices, where you learn about different professions and make informed decisions on your career choices. Email us at qip.career.choices@gmail.com. Today's guest is a foreign correspondent covering diplomacy and defense issues in Africa and Asia Pacific. He has been a featured contributor for a number of news outlets, including The Diplomat and Al Jazeera English. He is also the current vice chair of the International Correspondence Committee at the National Press Club. Please join me in welcoming Mr. Eddie Walsh to share with us his life as a journalist. Mr. Walsh, thank you for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
Thanks. So you have been a foreign correspondent for 10 years. Tell me, how did you get into this profession, or what made you decide this was the way to go?
Well, growing up, my mother was a journalist, and so the profession was always around me. And she gave it up to raise my brother and I. But throughout our entire childhood, we spoke about journalism and about her pursuits and interests. And she went back into radio when I was in elementary school. Nice. And during that period, it's a very formative period in your life. And I remember vividly hearing my mom on the radio and and asking her about what it was to be a journalist. And she always talked to me about why she wanted to be a journalist and the importance of having a free press and the importance of having people who would stand up and engage people on very difficult issues. And it instilled in me this desire to want to be that person. And when I went to undergraduate, I had an opportunity to study international studies, which I thought was very interesting, growing up in a Midwest environment where I didn't have the opportunity to travel abroad. I got to see the world, and that was very important. It sort of delayed my opportunity to go into journalism until after grad school. But while I was in grad school, I thought about it, and Wolf Blitzer had gone to my alma mater, and I started thinking about different opportunities. A lot of people who study foreign policy, they end up going into policy roles, they go into defense, they do all these things. I thought about journalism. I thought about how could I actually apply all of this expertise that I had learned and been really endowed with through the education in journalism. And I had the opportunity to go to The Economist as an intern in Southeast Asia, and that was really the beginning for me.
That sounds really exciting for just your education background and training. So you've shared with me one of the photos is at the White House. You just said that you have to ask some tough questions. Being a foreign correspondent, what kinds of questions do you ask the White House?
Well, it's hard to ask the White House questions because it's hard to get an interview with the president. But but when you're engaging with senior policymakers or senior military officials, a lot of the time you're doing it on background, and you can have obviously a much more open conversation, regardless whether it's the United States or a foreign government or somebody who's a track two source. The opportunity to really ask them the hard questions in a background interview is, you know, the threshold's lowered, and you have the opportunity to be more open, and they feel more comfortable. When you ask those questions in the middle of a press conference, which is on the record, you tend to get the spokesperson for whichever organization it is. And you tend to get a response that is far less open, but is more on point with what the grand strategy is for the organization.
I see. And why did you decide to focus on Asia or Africa?
For me, I didn't start out saying, I want to cover Asia, I want to cover Africa. I had not really traveled abroad until I went to college. And my freshman year, I had the opportunity to get out of the Midwest and explore the world a little bit. And I had roommates who were from abroad and from Asia and from the Middle East. And so I started traveling in those regions because I had friends that I could go and see and really be my tour guide to go through the region. And I just continued. And so the process for the next 5 years, I went to Africa, I went to Asia, I went to Europe. I had a chance to go to the Caribbean and parts of Latin America, and it was really sort of this developmental period for me to explore and see what I was passionate about. And when I graduated, it was the beginning of sort of the Asian century. The financial crisis was over in 1998, and the region was really starting to prop itself up again. And you saw the rise of China, and you saw the rise of Southeast Asia. And I thought it was going to be a very dynamic and interesting place to cover the issues I'm passionate about, which are diplomacy, defense, and trade.
Got it. So when it comes to diplomacy, I see you interview a lot of diplomats, ambassadors. What is it like to interview them, given that they are seeing you as someone who is not from that country, but is asking them tough questions about their country?
Yeah.